H-E-N-R-Y.
I like it when you go wild.
Wake up with Henry Hinton.
No, God, please, no, no.
This is Talk of the Town on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
Yeah, welcome in. Talk of the Town. Five minutes after eight. Good to have you here this morning. Talk of the Town brought to you this hour by our friends at Potash Corporora. More than a mining company, they're an important part of area communities where they support education in science, technology, engineering, and math through programs like Science Olympiad, Math Counts, and First Robotics Competition. Potash Corporora, coaching students for future careers. Welcome in to hour two here this morning, Tuesday morning, July 26th. Trent McGee is here with sports this morning. Morning, McGee.
Good morning, Hen.
See what's going on as we get ready for the Olympics.
Olympics. Rio.
And at the news desk this morning is Billy Weaver. Good morning, Weave. How are
good
you?
Good morning. Doing
nice
good.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
And Mark Rizzo is producing for radio this morning. Good morning, Rizzo.
Good morning, Henry.
How are you?
I'm doing well. Nice to see you.
Have we heard from Michael this week?
No.
He checked in from the Hojo in Trenton, New Jersey yet, where everybody goes to vacation.
He's on vacation, but he's still here, kind of.
How do you figure that?
He texts Ashton a lot.
He's texting Ashton, not you?
Well, to make sure that, you know, everything's
Ashton, he's texting you to make sure Rizzo's doing his job. Is that the way it goes? That's the way it goes. Well, at least he cares enough to text.
True.
He doesn't want me to yell at him Monday when he comes back. Like, why didn't you tell Rizzo this or that?
Mm-hmm.
That's what's going on. All right, it's good to be here. We're going to be at Krispy Kreme on Friday morning. It's our monthly visit to Krispy Kreme. They're going to have a lot going on down there this weekend with the Red Cross. So we'll be talking more about that as we get closer to it. We had this discussion last hour. I made the comment that there was this controversy about, let me preface this by saying that what we're about to talk about does not deserve the airtime we're going to give it, which is the case of many things.
Yes, true.
Yeah. So what?
But the question was whether or not
the first hour of the show. Yeah. I mean,
the question was: did Forrest Gump actually say life is like a box of chocolates? And there's this controversy on the internet that he did never say that.
He didn't
say
that.
So we went and looked at it, and I see Weaver was fighting me on this, and then he went and listened to the audio.
But it's a technicality.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it's
one
word.
He either said it or he didn't say it. Let me ask you this.
Okay.
You're on the witness stand.
Yes.
Did Forrest Gump say life is like a box of chocolates, yes or no?
No.
Thank you. That's all I wanted to know.
But now you have to explain what he did say.
No, I'm going to be like the defense attorney, just leaves the jury hanging with that.
That's how defense attorneys work, though. See, what people don't understand is that he said life was like a box of chocolate.
And see, a lot of people are arguing that that's not what he really said.
Well, he did. I
just
pulled up the video. I pulled up the video.
Turn it up.
Yeah.
I've got the audio clip right here. Here we go.
I could eat about 1.5 million of these.
Crank it up.
My mom always said life was like a box of chocolates.
Boom.
Never know what you're going to get.
Life was like a box of chocolates. That's what he said.
But later in the movie, when he's reflecting back and his mother is in bed, when she said, I caught the cancer, or when he says she caught the cancer, she says in the bed, well, Forrest, life's like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. So she says, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. But he says,
my mom always said,
was.
Life was like a box of chocolates.
Because he's referring to his dead mother.
You never know what you're going to get.
It's not the point. The famous scene is when he's sitting on the park bench.
Judge, you're ruling on a technicality.
He did not say life is like a box of chocolates.
True. That is true.
My
that
mama
is a true
always
statement.
Said life was like a box of chocolates. Yeah. So everybody it's gets that quote wrong.
Very true statement.
Yeah. There we go. See, once again, we've educated Weaver on something that he thought he knew, but he didn't know. There you go. Happy to be of service to you. There
Thank
we
you. Thank you.
The Lieutenant Governor will join us.
Lieutenant Dan.
That's how all this started, by the way.
People are probably wondering, let's how did they get on this conversation?
Let's ask the Lieutenant Governor. Lieutenant Governor, do you know whether or not Forrest Gump said life is like a box of chocolates? I'm sure he'll want to talk about that. Mm. The governor today, well, Dan Forrest is coming to Eastern North Carolina. He's going to be in Williamston today. Where's it going to be, Weave?
Williamston.
I know that.
Oh, Moratalk Park.
Moratalk Park, is that
town
right?
Hall, town hall meeting.
Town hall meeting. The governor today is welcoming in his old friend, Governor Scott Walker from Wisconsin, who is going to be, I think he's going to be in town for a couple of days from what I was told. Scott Walker is doing a Raleigh fundraiser this afternoon for Pat McCrory. You might remember Walker. You remember a year ago we all thought Scott Walker would be the nominee?
Yeah, sure did.
I mean, everybody thought he was the dead cinch to be the nominee. And he was the first one to flame out. Mm-hmm. You know why? Because life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Walker, early casualty in the GOP presidential camp primary, is in his second term as governor. He told North Carolina delegates at the convention last week that he is going to help Pat McCrory get reelected. McCrory faces a determined challenge from Democrat state attorney Roy Cooper, who is raising money from all sorts of unions and libos all over the place. Crazy. The McCrory fundraiser, which has a top ticket price of $1,000, is being held at the home of Grayson and Garland Tucker. I don't know them. People younger than 35 can get in for $100. Garland Tucker is chairman of Triangle Capital Corporation, a publicly traded company, and is the author of books of American conservatism. Now, that's how Governor McCrory is raising his money. How is Roy Cooper raising his money? Well, it's interesting. When the WikiLeaks thing came out this weekend, and they nailed Debbie Wasserman Blabbermouth Schultz, there were some emails that had Roy Cooper in them. they had a Roy Cooper connection. It appears that they had some email. You know the big argument that the Democrats make, that Republicans are in bed with Wall Street? Mm-hmm. Well, guess what? One of the emails from the WikiLeaks leaks this weekend was an email where someone is trying to set up a meeting with Roy Cooper and this guy from Goldman Sachs. This is what we see on the internet this morning from LadyLiberty1885.com. WikiLeaks DNC email leaks have a North Carolina connection. Democrat candidate for Governor Roy Cooper is mentioned in several of the leaked DNC emails. One such email is about a meeting Cooper allegedly was setting up with unnamed Goldman Sachs officials. The email in question was sent from Will Little of George Little Management Company to Joshua Block, who is a financial advisor at Goldman Sachs. Here's what it says. Hello, Josh. Well, first of all, it says from this guy, Will Little, to Joshua Block at Goldman Sachs. Subject, meeting with Attorney General Roy Cooper. So it was under the guise that this guy was North Carolina's attorney mm-hmm. general. Mm-hmm. Here's what it says. Hello, Josh. In speaking with my friend Zach Allen, who is arranging for Jeff and me to meet with Roy Cooper next Tuesday, Zach mentioned that Roy will be coming to Goldman Sachs headquarters next Wednesday and thought he might be able to arrange for you to meet him there rather than having to come up to the Regency the day before. By copy of this email to Zach, he will be your contact in order to effectuate such a meeting. So, again, if you're missing the point here, This is an email from Roy Cooper, Cooper's campaign operatives, or someone supporting Roy Cooper, trying to set up a meeting with someone at Goldman Sachs. Now, what is the reason? This guy, the guy that he refers to in this email, he refers to Jeff, which is apparently Little's little brother, George, who is also goes by the name of Jeff. And let's see. William Little landed in the number 9 slot for super PAC donors to President Obama. This guy that Cooper was trying to get a meeting with gave $150,000 to Obama in 2012. And campaign records show that he has donated to Roy Cooper's campaign. He's given Cooper $3,000 overall, and George Little, his brother, has contributed $1,000. Two donations occurred after the date of the leaked emails. The dates of the donations were April 26th of this year, May 18th of this year, and June 24th of this year. So, you know, these are the campaign donations from these guys at Goldman Sachs to Roy Cooper. But keep in mind that when, you know, people like Roy Cooper go see these huge donors in places like Goldman Sachs on Wall Street, what they're really trying to do is get them to donate to, let's say, the North Carolina Democratic Party. You know, a guy who would give Obama $150,000 in a very heated Southern governor's race, if he wanted to try to effect a change in the South with the Democrats taking over the state again, you know, he would be capable of giving $50,000, $25,000, whatever. And, of course, that would be illegal to give it directly to the campaign. The most you can give to a campaign or to a candidate is $5,100. But you can give the money to, let's say, the North Carolina Democratic Party. Let's say he gave $50,000 to the North Carolina Democratic Party. That money could be used for ads to support Roy Cooper. They just have to be placed by the party rather than by the campaign. So that's how they get away with this kind of thing. So the next time you hear Roy Cooper or Hillary Clinton scream that the Republicans are courting Wall Street, here it is in black and white. Roy Cooper, Goldman Sachs, end of story. And you want to know why Roy Cooper's campaign numbers look so good? This is why. It's outside money. He's going to New York to get money. Again, the governor of North Carolina is having a fundraiser here in North Carolina at the home of a businessman in Raleigh today trying to raise money. Here's Roy Cooper on Wall Street trying to raise money because that's where the liberals live. That's where the liberals are. That's where they're trying to go out and get the money. Now, they're getting some small donations inside North Carolina. Cooper's getting, you know, $2,500 campaign donations. But the big money, it looks like it's coming from places like Goldman Sachs. It's coming from labor unions, things like that. So every time you see those numbers and they come out and say, Roy Cooper has outraised North Carolina, just think about the number of times he's probably been to Wall Street. There's going to be a huge convention in Charlotte next week. The VFW is having a national convention in Charlotte. Did you hear about this? The veterans of foreign wars, and both of the presidential candidates are going to be there in Charlotte next week campaigning and speaking to the VFW. They're expecting more than 10,000 people, by the way. The VFW did not move their event out of Charlotte like the liberal NBA. Hillary Clinton will speak to the group on Monday morning in Charlotte. Donald Trump will speak to the group on Tuesday. So, again, it looks like Trump and Hillary spending a lot of time in North Carolina.
They are.
But neither one have been to eastern North Carolina.
Well, Trump said last night that people of North Carolina were going to get tired of seeing him. He's going to be here so much. So,
well, I mean, we need to get him over here to Greenville.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Need to work on that. Now that I'm out of the closet and on the Trump train, I'm going to
choo-choo. Don't you work on that.
I'm getting on it. I'm on the Trump train. McGee mentioned this in his sports earlier. Michael Jordan has now released a letter talking about the shooting deaths of blacks by police and the targeted killing of police officers, and he's donating $1,000 to the cause of each.
No, a million.
I'm sorry, $1 million to each, right? $2 million total. Mm-hmm. What did I say, 1,000?
Yeah.
$1 million, of course.
He spends $1,000 on cigars.
Oh, no doubt. Jordan lost his father July 23rd, 1993, when he was shot and killed. You remember the story where he was down around the story was that he pulled over to take a nap down in, around Duplin County or something, wasn't it? I always thought that was odd.
U.S. 74.
Where it was. Jordan's letter says, as a proud American, a father who lost his own dad in a senseless act of violence, and a black man, I have been deeply troubled by the deaths of African Americans at the hands of law enforcement and angered by the cowardly and hateful targeting of police officers, Jordan wrote. Jordan says he grieves with those affected by the recent shootings as he knows their pain. He wrote that racial tensions seem to be getting worse, but I can no longer stay silent. He's donating $1 million each to the International Association of Chiefs of Police, newly established Community Police Relations, and the NAACP Legal Defense Fund. Jordan wrote, we are privileged to live in the world's greatest country, a country that has provided my family and me the greatest of opportunities. The problems we face didn't happen overnight, and they won't be solved tomorrow, but if we all work together, we can foster great understanding, positive change, and create a more peaceful world for ourselves, our children, our families, and our communities. You think maybe he was, this was kind of a response to his business partner coming out?
I was going to bring that up because we talked about Jordan hadn't said anything on the NBA move in the All-Star
game. Well, this,
game.
But he doesn't mention NBA here, but is this a change of the subject moment for him? Because, you know, his business partner in the Charlotte Hornets came out and blamed the city of Charlotte City Council and mayor for the loss of the NBA, a clear support for Governor McCrory and the legislature. Jordan has never spoken on that. It's almost like he's saying, you know, there's bigger things for me to speak out on, and this is what I'm going to say.
Yeah, and instead, you right? As the fan or average person can now forget about the fact that I haven't said anything about the NBA moving the All-Star game.
Yeah.
Rather, I'm going to support this.
Right. All right, let's get a break. And Dan Forrest, the Lieutenant Governor of North Carolina, coming up in just about 8 minutes. But first, some news headlines from Billy Weaver right after this break. We'll be back with more Talk of the Town for Tuesday morning, July 26th. Stay with us.
Full-Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full-Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is now open. That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington. The city of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. You've got to see our large selection of Ram trucks. We have over 100 new Rams in stock. That's the largest in Eastern North Carolina.
Lease a new Ram 1500 Crew for just $299 a month and only $299 due at signing with the summer clearance event.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
News time at 25 after 8 o'clock. My friend Ray Franks just corrected me. The VFW conference, the 10,000 people, sure, is going on this week. Apparently it must have been yesterday and today. That is Trump going to be in Charlotte today? Maybe that's the deal. He's going over there
yes,
this morning.
It's starting. I'm going to have that in my news headlines.
Okay. Well, let's do that then. Here is Billy Weaver with our news from WITN. Good morning, B.
Good morning, Henry. It's now currently 8:26, 79 degrees in Greenville. I'm Billy Weaver, and this is a look at your WITN News headlines. Today's the day Hillary Clinton will become the first female presidential nominee from a major party. The Democratic National Convention started Monday under a cloud of controversy. Baltimore's Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake called the 47th convention to order, replacing outgoing party chair Debbie Wasserman Schultz. The mayor forgot the gavel, had to run off to get it, then return to the podium. Now, Wasserman Schultz stepped down in the wake of leaked emails that showed that DNC officials favored Clinton over Bernie Sanders in the primary. Sanders spoke last night urging his supporters to vote for Clinton. The theme of the DNC today is Mothers of the Movement. Speakers will include the mothers of people who died in police custody or as a result of police actions. Donald Trump makes a second campaign appearance today in North Carolina, fresh off the Republican National Convention. Trump rolled into Winston-Salem Monday and touched on a number of different topics that have been the staple of his campaign, such as trade in China, American jobs, and the fight against ISIS. Governor Pat McCrory introduced Trump's vice presidential pick, Mike Pence, McCrory's first official appearance with the Trump campaign. Trump will start the day in Charlotte at the Veterans of Foreign Wars National Convention before heading to Tampa for a fundraiser. So there's your answer there, Henry. McCrory's lieutenant governor running for his own reelection will be in the East this evening. Lieutenant Governor Dan Forrest, who will join us on the show later, is running with Governor Pat McCrory. He'll be hosting an old-fashioned town hall meeting in Williamston this evening. The family-friendly meeting is free and open to the public. It's expected to start at around 6 o'clock tonight at Moratok Park on River Drive. Since the event is outdoors, Forrest is encouraging that everyone bring their own chairs. And we're working to learn more this morning about the father who drowned in a brave attempt to save his daughters from a dangerous rip current. The man's name has not been released, but Atlantic Beach Fire Chief Adam Snyder says he was in Carteret County on vacation from out of state. The man jumped in the water at Shackelford Banks when his three daughters got caught up in a rip current on the West End. A nearby boat rescued the girls, but the father could not make it back to shore safely. Snyder says an off-duty paramedic started CPR on the man while crews continued to work on him until they arrived at Carteret Healthcare, where he was later pronounced dead. It is currently 8:29, 79 degrees in Greenville. I'm Billy Weaver, and that's a look at your WITN news headlines. Henry.
All right, 28 after 8 o'clock. Going to be very hot today. Let's get a break in because the lieutenant governor is waiting for us on the phone. We're going to get our break in so we can have plenty of time to talk to Dan Forrest. Stay with us, 29 after 8. We'll be right back with Lieutenant Governor Dan Forrest.
Camry SE's only $199
yes,
a month.
Hurry
in. Greenville Toyota's deals are getting hot. Camry SE's $199 a month. Plus, get 125% of book for trades. Only at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique
Thank
to
you,
your
brother.
Home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile and Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Don't get lost 'cause I'm waiting. Summer fever's waiting, boy.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsport, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Corollas, only $159 a month. Hurry in. Greenville Toyota's deals are getting hot, hot, hot. Corollas, $159 a month. Plus, get 125% of book for trades. Only at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
Talk of the Town here on a Tuesday morning, 26th day of July. And we mentioned all the campaign events going on in North Carolina today with Scott Walker in Raleigh with the governor and the lieutenant governor. Our friend Dan Forrest will be in Williamston tonight at 6 o'clock at Moratalk Park. And it is going to be a town hall meeting. The lieutenant governor is in the car driving east as we speak right now. We got him on the telephone. Good morning, Governor Forrest. How are you, sir?
Good morning, Henry. I'm doing great. How are you doing today?
And I hear you're on the way right now to God's country. You got a meeting in Edenton first, and then you're heading over to Williamston today. So we appreciate you taking time to hit the northeastern corner of the state, which, you know, sometimes we feel forgotten up there.
I understand. Yeah, it's, you know, not always on the beaten path for everybody, but it's always good to get out. And, you know, we're kind of making our way there through Nashville and Edenton and then Williamston later, where just, you know, some of my favorite people in North Carolina are up in Williamston. Just a great group of folks up there, and we're doing an old-fashioned town hall. We're doing a series of those, as you know, around the state. We bring our campaign bus out. We call it BYOC, Bring Your Own Chair. And let folks just come out and ask us questions and just kind of update folks as to what's been going on in our state over the last few years under Republican leadership.
So bring your own chair. You might want to bring some bottled water or something like that tonight. It's going to be a little warm, but 6 o'clock in the park. It's going to be a nice evening, but it's going to be hot. So now what's the format of the event in Williamson tonight, Mr. Lieutenant Governor?
Well, there's, you know, the only format is just come with your questions. You know, we kind of kick it off, and I just give folks a fairly brief overview about what we've been doing. As you know, Henry, our greatest challenge is just getting the truth out, that some of the things that really should be top headlines above the fold in our newspapers and leading the day on the evening news are nowhere to be found in the Main Street media. And so we have to go out and do it the old-fashioned way and meet people face-to-face and talk to them about what we've been doing. So that's really what it's about, is us sharing and then hearing what's important to the people of northeastern North Carolina, and hearing, you know, what specific things that they want to have done for the state, and now they want to see the state moving forward.
Of course, the big news on Friday was the decision, or I guess it was Thursday, the decision by the NBA, finally. Everybody knew it was coming. It was just a matter of when. And the NBA has now officially decided that they will not play the All-Star game in Charlotte. Some people are acting like the sky is falling. Other people are being more realistic about it. And of course, the truth of the matter is it's the height of hypocrisy that they would use this HB2 opportunity to make a statement like that when they're willing to continue to play games in places where people are, you know, women are treated like they are and gays are treated like they are, but still, they, you know, it's all about the left-wing agenda, it seems. So chalk up one for the lefties, but what's your response on that?
Yeah, I mean, I think that this is just par for the course. As you said, we knew it was coming. It was just a matter of time. It's a big business decision. You know, they have a lot of pressure from the Human Rights Campaign, who puts pressure on all these companies then, and the corporate interests then put pressure on folks like the NBA, because it's all about money and it's all about sponsorships. And so then they have to stand up and, you know, yell how discriminatory North Carolina is when they signed up to play the NBA All-Star game in Charlotte. The law is the same then as it is now. So nothing changed. And interestingly enough, as you mentioned about the height of hypocrisy, you know, the day after they came out with their announcement about pulling the All-Star game out of Charlotte, they started selling tickets for their game in China, where we know there's all kinds of human rights atrocities. And so it's pretty unbelievable. You know, I like to say it's not just an ideological battle. It's a political battle. We have 100 days till an election comes up, and they want to try to influence that election. But I firmly believe the people in North Carolina are a whole lot smarter than that. And they still don't want men going in little girls' bathrooms and showers and that sort of thing. That the bathroom should be a place of privacy and safety for the folks in North Carolina.
You know, we even saw some tweets coming out of Philadelphia from the Democratic National Convention yesterday that were very tell-all, if you ask me. People kind of cheering. Yeah. Cheering the idea that that North Carolina is losing the opportunities like the NBA All-Star Game. I mean, it just kind of goes to show. We know that Roy Cooper was on the telephone making phone calls trying to keep businesses from coming to North Carolina, which is a strange position for a guy that wants to be governor. But, you know, again, this is when things have gone as well as they have under your leadership and the governor's leadership in the last 3 years – in North Carolina, they've got to come up with some sort of a storyline to tell people why they need to vote for them instead of you.
Yeah, and I think it's a massive miscalculation on their part, Henry. This left-wing, radical, extremist overreach about opening up bathrooms and showers and locker rooms to women, to men, that's pretty bizarre, and they're even saying it on the stage last night at the Democrat convention as well, saying, you know, they think they're telling people which bathroom to use when they're really telling companies which state not to do business in.
Yeah.
Unbelievable that statement would even come out of somebody's mouth. We've known what bathroom to use for centuries here, and that's just not going to change.
All the polling on the lieutenant governor race for November looks very tight. Just like the governor's race, it's too close to call right now. Your race for lieutenant governor, too close to call. If people want change, you know, it's interesting that, you know, that's the kind of change that they'd be looking for in North Carolina. But things have gone so well with the economy, with the unemployment. I noticed the unemployment rate last month under 5% in North Carolina. That's an incredible turnaround in 3 years.
Absolutely. You know, almost cutting it 50% from the high eights, the high fours now for unemployment in the rate, creating 300,000 jobs in the last 3 years, and having going from a $3 billion deficit to a $500 million surplus, putting over $1 billion away in the rainy day fund for the first time ever, to paying off massive debts to the federal government and putting away billions of dollars in the rainy day fund for unemployment. So that's secure now. And you know, you can go on and on and on down the list. You know, our GDP is one of the largest in the world now. We're between Sweden and Taiwan for our GDP in North Carolina, the ninth largest state. And, you know, people want to continue moving here. You know, what we might not get is the folks that are a bunch of leftists that don't have the same values that people in North Carolina have. But you know what? That's okay. It's called America. We have 50 states, and there's a lot of places for people to go that have certain ideals and opinions and values. And but North Carolina is going to continue to be a great state, attracting business and attracting people from all over the world. And so we're proud of the work we've done. And we think once we get the story out, that the people in North Carolina will be proud of that, too.
You know, it's really interesting. A good friend of mine over the weekend made the observation that all of this LGBT stuff, transgender bathrooms and all that, has come to the forefront because you guys have taken away the Democrats' ability to campaign on anything else.
they really can't
campaign on education anymore because of the great work that you've done with school teacher salaries and the support, which has been unprecedented in North Carolina for school teachers. They can't campaign on that. They can't campaign on the economy. So it's almost like you've created your own monster here, Mr. Lieutenant Governor, with this LGBT thing. Because, but you know, isn't it amazing that they think that is the way to go to convince the people of North Carolina to make a change in government?
Yeah, I mean, it really shows you what's on their mind and what they think is important and what they're willing to bring to the forefront. And really what it shows you is they have no vision and for the state of North Carolina and where it should be going. So they have to play into the hands of these extremists across our country, like the Human Rights Campaign, who just want to push a radical left-wing agenda. And I don't think North Carolina are ready for that. And like I said earlier, I think it's a big miscalculation on their part, and that's going to show up in November.
Lieutenant Governor Dan Forrest, are you going to be in the Ron Forrest run van to the big bus tonight?
We'll have the bus out there tonight at Moritok Park in Williamson out on River Drive, and we hope that the folks in Williamson that are listening will come out with their questions.
If you want to put this in your GPS, folks, if you want to figure out how to get to where the town hall meeting is going to be tonight, the address is 102 River Road in Williamson. It's right on the banks of the Roanoke River. Should be a fun night tonight. Going to be warm. Bring some bottled water. Bring your lawn chairs and go out and spend some time tonight with North Carolina's great Lieutenant Governor. I say this to you privately, Mr. Lieutenant Governor, but I'll say it publicly as well. Every time I see you on national television, I'm proud that you're my Lieutenant Governor. You do a great job of representing our state.
Well, thank you so much, Henry, and thank you for everything you do on the radio. Get the truth out. Get the message out for the people in North Carolina.
Good luck. I'm sure you'll have a big crowd tonight. Stay cool.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Talk to you later.
Bye now.
Dan Forrest, Lieutenant Governor of North Carolina. 8:43, 17 in front of 9 o'clock, and the Talk of the Town brought to you in part this morning by our friends at Cellular Warehouse. And, of course, our friend Toby Williams, Cellular Warehouse, making your life easier. Why would you waste your time standing in line at a store when all you really need to do is call the professional outside sales team, and they will come to you? And now, if you want to see them, you can go to Facebook as well and put in the search for Cellular Warehouse. Cellular Warehouse. I'm going to give you the telephone number in a minute to call. This is Toby's personal cell phone number, and he will personally help you with all your wireless needs, or he'll turn you over to one of his great salespeople. They've got people that travel the eastern part of the state all the way from Elizabeth City to Williams Wilmington, all the way out to Goldsboro. Summer's here, and you should be spending your time outdoors enjoying life and not in a store pulling your hair out, waiting in line for your number to be called. It's the most frustrating thing you can possibly do, is have to go to a cell phone store and wait for them to wait on you. And then, I'm telling you, just call Toby, people. Just call Toby. That is my message to you today. He's an authorized U.S. Cellular agent. He'll come to your house. He'll come to your office. He'll come to the golf course. He's come to the golf course for me twice. Has he not, McGee? He came and left a loaner phone when I dropped my phone in the water. He came to the golf course and left a loaner phone at the pro shop. That is absolutely a 100% true story. Here's the number to call if you want to get started with Cellular Warehouse, 799-7051. It's 252-799-7051. That is Toby Williams' personal cell phone number. Call him today. If you're not a customer of Cellular Warehouse yet, why not? I promise you, one call, you'll change your mind and you'll be part of the team with Cellular Warehouse. Call Toby Williams today, 252-799-7051. 8:45. We'll be back. Is this David Bowie or Vanilla Ice? You better not be playing Vanilla Ice. Oh, it's the David Bowie version of Pressure. All right, we'll be back. More Talk of the Town. Crank this up. I like this. We'll be back with more Talk of the Town after this.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. Looking for an SUV? Come check out our great lineup of Jeeps.
Lease a new Jeep Compass for just $99 a month with the summer clearance event. Also, check out Eastern North Carolina's largest selection of Jeep Cherokees, Grand Cherokees, and Wranglers.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is now open. That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington. The city of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Eleven minutes in front of nine. Happy birthday to Mr. Mick Jagger today. He is 72 years old. Still getting her done, isn't he?
He is. Yep.
Helen Mirren, the great actor, is 71 today. Kevin Spacey, the actor, 57 years old today. And ECU's own Sandra Bullock is 52 years old today. Still never met Sandra Bullock, but it's on my to-do list. I'd like to meet her.
Yours and a lot of other guys.
We'd like to have her here in Greenville.
Sure.
I know a lot of work's been done on that. Trying to get her to come back, but so far haven't been able to work it out. It is 10 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. Talk of the Town brought to you in part this morning by Children's World Learning Center and Academy. School is about to start here in just a few weeks, and Children's World will be enrolling first grade students. They still have some spots available. I was over there talking to Tony Walden last week, actually, and there are some first grade spots available, but you better hurry.
Yes, you better.
If you want to get them in. You working on that,
There's
too?
There's about to be one spot available.
This is for first grade.
Oh, yeah, yeah, sorry.
This is for first grade.
Yeah.
So Children's World Learning Center on the great new location on Arlington Boulevard. They're going to have birth through fifth grade in the next few years. They're still looking for teachers. If you'd like to check it out, call Children's World at 252-215-9032. 252-215-9032. Just like McGee, I've known Tony and Billy Walden and their sons a long, long time, and they are great local people that run a great local business, and they're trustworthy. When you're dropping your kids off for the day, you can be sure that they're going to be taken well care of. And, first grade is a big deal also. They got a great first grade teacher this year. If you want to find out more, I suggest that you stop by Arlington Boulevard at Children's World Learning Center Academy for a tour, or you can just call them at 252-215-9032. They have four locations now in Greenville. Children's World on Johns Hopkins Drive near the hospital. Children's World on Greenville Boulevard, a Child's Place on Moy Drive, which is daycare, child care for Vidant employees. And, of course, the new Children's World Learning Center and Academy on Arlington Boulevard. Call them at 215-9032. All right, let's check some sports headlines now. Here is McGee on sports.
All right, Michael Jordan announced on Monday he's giving $1 million each to the Institute for Community Police Relations and $1 million to the NAACP Legal Defense Fund to help build trust between blacks and law enforcement following several disturbing clashes around the country. Now, if you remember, Jordan's father was killed back in 1993 in a late-night carjacking along U.S. 74. So he certainly can relate to losing loved ones, certainly close to him. Jordan urged the country to come together despite the recent uptick in racially charged incidents between African Americans and police. Some ECU football news. ECU seniors Deshaun Amos and Zay Jones will join first-year head football coach Scotty Montgomery as the Pirates' representatives at the American Athletic Conference Football Media Days in Providence, Rhode Island. The event is scheduled for August 1st through the 2nd of next week. We're not 39 days away from the Pirates' season opener against Western Carolina. ACC football media members picked Clemson to win the ACC. No surprise there. The Tigers are coming off a 14-1 season that included a win against North Carolina in the ACC championship game and a trip to the college football playoff title game where Clemson lost to Alabama. And a big trade in Major League Baseball on Monday as the Chicago Cubs acquired four-time All-Star Aroldis Chapman from the Yankees. The Yankees received a four-player package headlined by top shortstop prospect Gleyber Torres. Also includes Nuber native Adam Warren in that mix as well. He will be there with the Yankees too. Hint.
Okay. Our sports update brought to you by Suddenlink. If you are looking for at fast internet, you can't get any faster than internet, folks. And, of course, some of the new things that they're featuring, you can get Suddenlink's TiVo and instant access to Hulu, which is a big, big deal these days. If you are not into Hulu and Netflix and all the great things that you can get now by being a Suddenlink and a TiVo customer, you need to call them and sign up today. But the big thing, of course, is their internet. It only gets better. They let you choose the speed and data plan that you want now at Suddenlink. They've got unlimited data plans if you're into gaming or you need it for research or something like that. And then, of course, you get instant access to Hulu with your Suddenlink account. You can now easily search and watch your favorite TV shows directly from TiVo. Catch up on the latest episodes of Hulu's popular original series like 11-22-63. If you haven't seen that, that's the James Franco series about the Kennedy assassination. Very interesting. I watched that already. The Mindy Project, which features our friend Beth Grant. Speaking of ECU graduates, Beth has a prominent role in the Mindy Project. You can check that out. And The Path and Casual. So if you're going on vacation, you can schedule your TiVo to record your favorite shows if you have Suddenlink, or you can keep up with all your favorite programming on the go with your mobile device using the Suddenlink To Go app. Make the switch right now during Switch and Shout, and you'll get the SL200 HD TV, which will get you over 200 high-def channels, 50 meg internet, and phone service, all just $69 a month, the low price of $69 a month. All of that I've talked about, just $69 a month. Call them today at 866-432-1184, 866-432-1184, or visit them at suddenlink.com. And don't forget, 30-day money-back guarantee and 24/7 live and local customer service. All right, 5 minutes in front of 8 o'clock. We are about done for today, McGee. Good to have you here, my friend.
Good to be here.
Again, thanks to Lieutenant Governor Dan Forrest for being on with us. If again, if you're planning on going out to be with the Lieutenant Governor tonight, His town hall meeting will take place in Williamston from 6 o'clock on. Starts at 6. It's in Moratalk Park, and the location is 102 River Road in Williamson, 102 River Road. The lieutenant governor is also going to be up in Edenton today. I asked him if he had any public appearances in Edenton. He said no, he was up there for a few meetings today with folks. But he will be live and accessible tonight at Moratalk Park at 6 o'clock, 102 River Road. He'll be out there in his Run Forest Run. Have you seen the big bus?
I have.
It's got Run Forest Run on the side. And Weaver got out of here before he got to say something about Lieutenant Dan.
Oh, we knew he would.
Lieutenant Dan. A lot of Forrest Gump connections there with our lieutenant governor. All right, thanks to everybody for being here today. We're back in the studio tomorrow and Thursday. Krispy Kreme live remote coming up on Friday morning. Thanks to Mark Rizzo doing a great job producing while Mike's on vacation this week. We'll see you tomorrow, everybody. Have a great and try to stay cool Tuesday.
Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsfort, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
And here we have 1893 from the makers of Pepsi Cola. I'm gonna swirl it. I'm gonna smell it. I'm just gonna take one small sip.
Kinda seems like more than a sip.
Yeah, let me show you. Refined.
1893, made with cola nut extract and real sugar. Boldly blended cola.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. You've got to see our large selection of Ram trucks. We have over 100 new Rams in stock. That's the largest in Eastern North Carolina.
Lease a new Ram 1500 Crew for just $299 a month and only $299 due at signing with the summer clearance event.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville. We'll be right back.